meters above central Hamburg. Simone Jung is conducting the Hamburg Philharmonic from up here. Her musicians are scattered across the city and can only see the conductor on a monitor. They're playing Brahms' Second Symphony. Via a loudspeaker, they can hear an earlier recording of the same concert. This fish market hall is one of 50 different locations where the musicians are giving a free performance.
I think it's incredible. I heard about it very late and I'm glad I found it. I think it's great to see them live this way.
Good advertising and good entertainment.
The Church of St. Michael, affectionately known by the locals as Michel. The Australian head conductor Simone Jung will direct the orchestra from the viewing platform, even though she won't be able to see them.
This exciting, if somewhat crazy, project will bring the orchestra into contact with the people of the city. We identify very strongly with the city, and we want to show that symbolically and musically.
The Millantor Stadium is the home of cult football club St. Pauli. Sebastian Gaeta is getting ready for his performance on the cello. He's a lifelong season ticket holder.
It's definitely a declaration of love for Hamburg. They've selected very interesting places that are very important for the city. Hamburg's my hometown and I would have played anywhere, but my preference was naturally for the Millantor Stadium.
First violinist Monika Brugeier and her colleague Dylan Naylor are performing at the fish market. It's a special evening for everyone involved.
It's exciting. You have to concentrate much more than in the concert hall because there are lots of distractions and the conductor is usually a lot bigger and we can always see them. It's very difficult to look from the sheet music to the screen and then back again without losing your place or losing sight of your colleague.
Double bass player Tobias Grova is playing in the foyer of the Hotel Atlantic. 71 orchestra members are playing at 50 venues to a total audience of 10,000.
We did a small-scale rehearsal in various rooms of the State Opera House. I was in the conductor's room, the camera was on me, and the musicians were scattered in little groups throughout the building. Each room had a monitor and speakers, and it worked remarkably well.
A recording of the concert will be available for viewing on the internet at the end of the week.